ATR number 544/69/625, Crossroads episode 1182, part 1, take 1.
Kathy, darling. Kathy Knight. I've often spoken about her.
It's quite all right. I'm sure he's never even mentioned me. Oh, you are an idiot, saucebox.
That's what they used to call me in medical school.
Oh, you two were students together.
Yes, I was in my fourth year and Kathy was in her first.
And last. I just couldn't stay the course, I'm afraid. Couldn't handle all those nasty little ankle wounds.
You could say she was defeated.
Oh, law. Still making those dreadful puns. You haven't changed a bit. I don't know how you stand it.
Oh, I managed to survive. I'm really sorry about the mess, but I've got a bit of a cold.
Yes, I can see. How dreary for you.
Oh, you know, it's her fourth since October. I don't even need a calendar. When she wakes up with a red nose, I know it must be the 1st of October.
Oh, really, darling? Anyone would think I spend the winter with my feet in a mustard bath and my head in a...
Achoo! Bless you.
Oh, thank you.
I'm afraid I'm one of the lucky ones. I never seem to catch colds. Well, almost never. Have you tried the cold water cure? Gallons and gallons of ice cold water drunk straight off.
Oh, no. I think a nice hot cup of tea is in order. Sarah?
What?
A cup of tea?
Oh, yes, please, darling. How sweet of you. I'd love a cup.
Toasted tea cake, 2 cream buns and a pot of tea for 2.
Buttered
please.
Scone and a pot of tea for 3, please.
Oh, hang on.
I was first.
All right, don't blow your cool, girl. They won't run away.
Tish, have you seen Mum?
Oh, I think she went home.
Oh, she didn't say anything.
Well, it's not very convenient with all of these people turning up wanting tea in the middle of a wedding reception.
Shall I go and phone Mr. Lovejoy?
Oh, no, don't worry about that. Just be an angel and take these through, will you?
Oh, right.
That's what I love about you, Amy. Your smiling face makes the customers think a hot crumpet.
Come on, the night is getting restless out there. They're dying of thirst.
We know.
Well, it's critical, Amy. There's an old woman who's been a dog bowl 3 times.
Here you are, Amy. Tom, that's yours.
And there's another lot who wants a tea north, so you better tease them. Excuse me, Miss Turtle, but have you got potato bogging your petunias?
Is that China one?
You are?
China tea. I did ask for China tea.
Oh, stick a pound of water jug, no one knows the difference. Anyway, I want to have a word with you. I've got a proposition to put to you.
Oh, not another.
I've been thinking, my love. You're going to be needing a lot of fancy gear for this, too.
Well, I can't afford any fancy gear.
Well, what I want, first impressions, that's what matters. Someone with a bit like it, you know. Now, meet me down at Miss Gill's boutique first in the morning, we'll sort something sexy out.
I'm not having you buy my clothes for me, Archie. What do you think I am?
We're going 50-50, my dear.
Can't have you buy me clothes for me.
Look, you're merely my client. I'm sticking a few quid in your period out your winnings, alright?
Well...
Nah, I'll tell you what we'll do. We want something with a bit of life in it, you know? One lot of colour and a lot of glitter on it.
How revolting.
Burnt orange.
I beg your pardon?
This wall, it just screams out. Orange.
Oh, darling, I forgot to tell you. Kathy moved from the human interior to the bricks and mortar variety.
Pearl grey, yes. I think it would do.
Well, actually, this room has just been decorated.
You don't mind if I'm perfectly frank, do you?
Of course not.
Sue him.
What?
Sue him. It's hopeless. Completely wrong.
Well, we were perfectly satisfied. As a matter of fact, the dining room's just about to be decorated. That's why I'm reading in here. Perhaps you'd like to give it your professional opinion to stop us from making any more mistakes. More tea?
Please.
Oh, I must go and get some more.
I'll go, darling.
Oh, no. You stay here and look after Miss Knight. I'll manage.
You just want to pull it down her neck.
taste. Finish it. Okay, how's it feel, Matt?
Better.
Good. Well, get some rest.
Oh, no, don't go. Stay and talk for a bit.
Right. What do you want to talk about?
You.
Good Lord. Can't you find anything more interesting to talk about than that? How about the wedding?
Darling.
I mean, personally, I feel the chief bridesmaid went away with the whole show.
I know you hate talking about business these days, but I am worried about you.
Oh, well, I'm staying afloat, keeping busy. You've seen to that. And I'm having the time of my life reorganising this motel.
And I thought I was being so clever.
Yes. Get him interested in something new and he won't have time to brood. That is the oldest trick in the matrimonial book.
Oh, dear.
You were right, though, darling. It has helped.
How are you getting along with Nick?
Oh, all right. He's a bit on the humorless side, though, isn't he?
Oh, yes, he takes his job very seriously. I suppose that makes him a bit stuffy.
Well, he's your employee, darling, not mine. But personally, I find him a touch ruthless for my taste.
Oh, look who's talking.
Yes, I know. But I have a lot of weight to carry. At least I did have.
You still do. Visitors?
We're not expecting anyone, are we?
Not that I know of. Oh, it'll be some tradesmen, I expect. Amy can handle it.
Good Lord. What would we do before that woman came along? I mean, who'd answer the answer? Fill the kettle. Cook the meals.
A poor little harassed woman by the name of Meg Ryder. Oh, I forgot to mention. Did you know that in addition to her domestic talents, Mrs. Sturtle has nursing experience?
Did she tell you that, did she?
Yes. So you needn't worry about me being properly looked after.
Well, I'm not too sure about that.
Oh, darling, it's the obvious solution. Amy can take care of all the dreary business of medicine and trays and things, and you won't have to spend so much time at home.
Well, we shall see what your doctor has to say before you go making any more plans. Besides, I'm sure Miss Turtle has quite enough in her hands in this hotel already.
I had no idea they made such drastic alterations.
You must come down and see what we've done with the place. You're looking.
Oh, excuse me.
I'm not sure that I shall. I was rather fond of Crossroads the way it was.
Hello? Speaking? Ah, yes, Malcolm. No, we've finished tea. Oh, Lord, when did this happen? Just after I'd left? Well, yes, I'll come round, of course, at once.
No, don't do that. Yes, she's much better now. No need to drag you out.
Derek, you stay right where you are. I'm fine. No, really. Malcolm's just being a bit difficult. He doesn't like the idea of my being nursed by Amy Turtle. She is qualified, you know. Yes, she's got a medal to prove it. Best nurse of her year or something. Didn't she mention it to you?
Oh, no. How extraordinary. Well, look, Meg, I'll pop round first thing in the morning and we can talk about Mrs. Turtle then.
All right. But I don't see there's any problem. All right. Bye.
Darling, Miss Knight is going now.
Oh, I do wish you'd call me Kathy.
Oh, I had hoped you'd be spending the rest of the evening with us.
Oh, I would like to, but I'm afraid I've got quite a lot of work to be catching up on.
Well, it was so nice. You must come again, Miss. Kathy.
Oh, well, she'll be popping in and out all of the time now.
Really? Will she?
Yes, you know, I've got a feeling you two are going to get on like a house on fire.
Yes, of course.
Well, look, dear, you stay here and nurse your cold and I'll see Kathy out.
Okay.
Well, goodbye, Sarah. It was lovely to meet you.
Goodbye.
That was lovely, wasn't it?
Delightful.
Fancy bumping into her after all these years. Dear old Kathy, you know she hasn't changed a bit.
Really?
Yes, you liked her? I mean, she's a charming person, isn't she?
Oh, she's quite amusing. Tact isn't her strong point, though, is it? I mean, all that criticism about the decoration.
Yes, that was funny. I didn't dare catch your eye.
Yes, I noticed.
Oh, look, darling, how is she to know you've just redecorated it yourself?
Well, would you walk into somebody else's house and start bitching about the decoration?
Well, no, but she is a professional, I suppose. You must make exceptions for the experts. They get carried away.
Yes, the further the better.
Look, darling. Maybe we invite her over for dinner tomorrow night. Start all over.
Idiot saucebox, indeed.
We'll invite her for dinner.
Yes, all right. Be careful, you might catch a cold.
Thank you. Archie, what do you want?
What do I want? Well, tell you what I want. Turn to a right little Carnaby Street, this place, isn't it?
How about that, then?
A bit on the teeny bopper side for you, I would say. I see you more as a youthful mature.
Well, I want someone with a bit more glitter on, you know, with fringes, a bit frilly art.
Well, the party dresses are over there.
Oh, yes, that's more like it.
Right, now that's it. The joke's over. Out you go.
Listen here, I'm a bona fide customer.
You're what?
That's right.
Oh, come on.
It's all right, Jelly's with me.
It's about time you turned up.
It's only 9 o'clock. Have you found anything?
Yeah, found something all right. Have a look at that.
Oh, that's no good. The skirt's too tight.
What do you mean, too tight?
Well, I've got to sort of move about a bit. Hey, what about this?
Oh, no, you're not wearing that.
Why not?
Well, in the first case, it's green.
What's wrong with green?
Green's unlucky, love.
Well, I wear it all the time.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. Perhaps you're right.
How about this one, then?
Oh, yeah! That's great!
Suits you right down to the ground and likely up to the...
Yes. What?
Now, before we go any further, I'd like to know who's paying for this.
Cheers.
Morning.
Good morning. How's May?
Ah, she's much better now. Taking it easy, of course.
Yes, well, we were worried about her at the reception.
Yes, so was I. Of course, Derek did warn her not to overdo things.
Yes, well, she's always so full of life. I don't understand what she could have done to make herself feel like that.
No, nor do I, Tish. I wish I did. By the way, thank you for the flowers. They were from you, weren't they?
Yes, they were. I was hoping they might cheer her up. How did you know? I didn't put a note in.
Meg knew. Said only one person would think to send flowers in the middle of all this wedding excitement. She tells me to thank you and send you her love. Anything from the agency?
No, I'm afraid not. But the ad is in the newspaper. Look. Wanted receptionist. I expect the phone to start ringing at any moment.
They'll never find anyone. Too far from Birmingham.
Has Mr. Lovejoy been shouting for me?
Yes, I covered up for you.
It's going to cost you, though.
Have you come into a fortune lately?
What?
Have any more clothes this month?
Well, you've got to spend it to make it, Mrs. T.
Shut up, Danny.
Oops.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing. Danny was just having a little joke.
Well, will it take for being funny?
Go on, then. Let's have a look at it.
All right, but I'm not taking it out of the box. What do you think?
Great. From what I can see in him. Hey. Try the purple one on.
No, I can't. Not on here.
Oh, you're going to be a knockout in this, kid.
Yeah, if I don't back out first.
Oh, go on. You wouldn't do that.
Yeah, but I might not be any good at it, Anne. I don't want to let Archie down now, do I?
Oh, look, love. There's nothing to worry about. All you need is nerve and stamina.
Yeah, well, I'm a bit out of breath this morning.
Well, you'll have to go into training then, won't you?
What? Running round the village in a little green tracksuit.
Well, you're going to need all the energy you can get for what's in front of you. Hey, is that the time? I better be moving.
Yes, we do. Oh, great. Could you come down in your lunch hour? About 1:30. Excellent.
Mr. Ryder, can I have a word with you, please?
Yes, Danny. What is it?
Yes, well, you know where we are. That's right, straight through the village.
Is that somebody ringing about the receptionist job?
Well, could I get your address?
Well, I hope she's a swinger. But a bit short on talent round here.
Well, what about Diane? Doesn't she count as talent?
Well, she's already spoken for, isn't she? I think Vince would have something to say if I tried to move in there. Anyway, just between you and me, sir, Diane's not really my type. I like mine sultry and sophisticated.
All right, well, thank you very much, Mrs. Beckett. Goodbye.
Well, if,
Well, our first applicant. She's coming to see you at 1:30.
Well, if, you need any help, Mr.
Well,
Ryder...
you're the last person I'd call in. By the way, I'd like you to sit in on this, Tish. If you don't mind.
Of course, but I can't stay too long. I've promised to meet Derek in the boutique.
Well then, Danny, what is it you wanted to talk to me about?
Ah, yes, Mr. Ryder. It's about me nights off, sir.
Well, I'm afraid that's not my department, old chap. You'll have to take it up with the boss.
My boss? But I thought... Who?
Mr. Lovejoy.
Oh, Mr. Lovejoy. Blimey, I don't stand a snowballs.
Well, I suppose I'd better be getting on with some work, then.
Oh, Tish, if Meg calls, could you tell her I'll be over at the garage for the next half hour or so?
Yes, okay, bye.
Oh, Amy, you needn't have bothered. I'm coming down.
You know what Dr. Maynard said?
Oh, we'll just put it down over there. And after that, I think I shall go over to the motel.
You have to go over there.
Well, if you mean am I indispensable, then no. But I want to go. It's my life. And I can't very well sit round here all day getting in your way.
Well, I don't suppose I can stop you. Don't forget to take this, will you?
Oh, beastly stuff. Want to have a cup of coffee?
What is it? Mrs. Reiser? Okay. Sit down. Look, put your head down, right down.
Oh, I felt a bit giddy. This awful ringing in my ears. It's all right, it's passing off now.
I didn't think you should have got up. I'll phone Dr. Maynard.
No, don't do that. It's not as bad as all that. Anyway, he's coming in later. He knows what it is. He's treating it.
Now back to bed.
All right. I'll be all right, I'm sure.
What do you think?
I like it. I think it's very pretty.
Well, I've got it in blue or pink.
Oh, no, that's Sarah's colouring. She looked lovely in it.
Very difficult, you know, choosing a dress secretively for the wife.
Well, why be so secretive then?
Well, it's supposed to be a surprise, Mother. Can hardly surprise with it if she's trying it on for size, can I?
Well, you'll have to just take a chance on its fitting her then.
All right, I'll have that one then.
Well, look, if it doesn't fit, then you can always bring it back and have it altered. And if she absolutely hates it, she can always come back and choose another one.
No, that's the one. Could you keep it in the shop till just before Christmas?
Of course.
I've got nowhere to hide it at home.
Have some jolly nice things, Jill. You know, I think that this would suit Meg.
I don't know. It's not really her colour. Although, it might suit her.
I was thinking of popping down and see her this evening. Shan't stay. Just nip in and say hello.
Oh, good. I think she'd like that. Think she's feeling a bit cut off from her friends at the moment.
Yes, I was just saying to Markham this morning, I wish you were still at the motel. Things were so much easier.
Here we are.
Do you want a receipt?
No, the cheque stub's enough for me.
Of course, she's got Mrs. Turtle to keep her company.
Personally, I'd rather be without that sort of company.
Oh no, not you too.
You know, I understand how you feel, Jill, but the more I think about it, the more convinced I am that she didn't do it.
Didn't do what?
The murder.
Murder?
Ha ha ha!